Hello viewers, in this video I'm going to solve the questions 1 to 20 of exercise 7.2 in chapter 7 integrals. Exercise 7.2, the question says integrate the functions in exercises 1 to 37. So the first function is 2x by 1 plus x square, that is we have to find I is equal to integral 2x by 1 plus x square dx. We can solve these kind of problems using the method integration by substitution. That is, we can take some function. Here let us take 1 plus x square as t, so that we will get 2x dx. If we differentiate, we get 2x dx is equal to dt. So we can substitute 1 plus x square as t and 2x dx as dt, and we can simplify it and integrate the function easily. This is called integration by substitution. So what happens to the given integral? I is equal to 2x dx is dt, and 1 plus x square we have taken it as t. So integral dt by t. So this is equal to log mod t plus c. Since we have taken t as 1 plus x square, we have to rewrite this in terms of x. So this is equal to log mod 1 plus x square plus c. So this is I. I hope this is clear. Let us move on to the next question. The second question is log x the whole square divided by x. That is, I is equal to integral log x whole square by x dx. Now let us put log x is equal to t, then dx by x will be equal to dt. Now what will happen to our integral? I is equal to integral t square dt. We know what is integral t square dt. It is t cube by 3 plus c. Now we have to substitute our t in terms of x. So this is equal to log x the whole cube by 3 plus c. I hope this is clear. Next question, 1 by x plus x log x. Let us take I is equal to integral 1 by, I am taking x outside, x into 1 plus log x dx. Now we can put 1 plus log x as t, then dx by x will become dt. Therefore I is equal to integral dx by x is dt, and 1 plus log x we have taken as t. So it is dt divided by t. So we know what is dt by t is equal to log mod t. So t we have taken 1 plus log x. So this is equal to log mod 1 plus, I forgot to put the constant, plus c. So the answer is log mod 1 plus log x plus c. So this is the answer. So I is equal to log mod 1 plus log x plus c. Next question is sin x into sin of cos x. That is, I is equal to integral sin x into sin of cos x dx. Let us put the cos x is equal to t, then sin x dx will be equal to minus dt. Therefore what happens to our I? I is equal to integral, this sin x dx will become minus dt, and sin of cos x is sin t into minus dt. This is equal to minus integral sin t dt. Integral sin t dt is minus cos t. So minus of minus cos t plus c. So this becomes plus cos t, and for t we can substitute cos of cos x plus c. I hope this is clear. So we have got the question: integral sin x into sin of cos x dx is equal to cos of cos x plus c. We move on to the next question: sin ax plus b cos ax plus b. So we have to find I is equal to integral sin ax plus b cos ax plus b dx. Now we can put sin ax plus b equal to t, then cos ax plus b dx is equal to dt by a. So we have cos ax plus b into dx is equal to dt by a. So our given integral becomes I is equal to 1 by a integral t dt. So this is equal to 1 by a into t square by 2 plus c. We have taken t as sin ax plus b. So this is equal to sin square ax plus b divided by 2a plus c. The next question is square root of ax plus b. Here square root of ax plus b we can write directly I is equal to integral ax plus b the whole raised to half into dx. So this is equal to 1 by a into ax plus b the whole raised to half plus 1. It is 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2 plus c. So this is equal to 2 by 3a into ax plus b the whole raised to 3 by 2 plus c. The next one, x square root of x plus 2. That is, we have to find I is equal to integral x square root of x plus 2 dx. Let us put x plus 2 as t, then dx will be equal to dt. So I will be integral, since we have taken x plus 2 as t, we get x as t minus 2. So here we can put t minus 2 into square root of t dt. So this is equal to integral t into square root of t raised to 3 by 2 dt minus 2 integral t raised to half dt. Square root of t, I am writing it as t raised to half. So this is equal to t raised to 3 by 2 plus 1. It is t raised to 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2 minus 2 into integral t raised to half dt is t raised to half plus 1 t raised to 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 plus c. We can substitute t as x plus 2. So this is equal to 2 by 5 into x plus 2 the whole raised to 5 by 2 minus 4 by 3 into x plus 2 the whole raised to 3 by 2 plus c. I hope this is clear. Next one, eighth one, x into square root of 1 plus 2x square. So I is equal to integral x into square root of 1 plus 2x square dx. So this is equal, Now let us put 1 plus 2x square as t. On differentiating, we get 4x dx is equal to dt, or x dx is equal to 1 by 4 dt. So what will happen to our I will be 1 by 4 integral square root of t dt. So this is equal to 1 by 4 into integral square root of t dt is integral t raised to half dt. So it is t raised to half plus 1, t raised to 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2 plus c. So on simplification, we get this is equal to 1 by 6. We can substitute t as 1 plus 2x square the whole raised to 3 by 2 plus c. The next question is 4x plus 2 into square root of x square plus x plus 1. So let us take I is equal to integral 4x plus 2, or I am taking 2 outside, 2 into 2x plus 1 into square root of x square plus x plus 1 into dx. Now let us put x square plus x plus 1 is equal to t. Then 2x plus 1 into dx will be dt. Therefore I is equal to integral 2 square root of t dt. This is equal to 2 into integral square root of t dt is, it is t raised to half plus 1, which is 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2 plus c. So this is equal to 4 by 3 into, I can substitute the t as x square plus x plus 1. So 4 by 3 into x square plus x plus 1 the whole raised to 3 by 2 plus. I hope this is clear. The next question, 1 by x minus square root of x. So let us take I is equal to integral dx by, I am taking square root of x outside, so inside it will be square root of x minus 1. Now let us put square root of x minus 1 as t. Then on differentiating, we get 1 by 2 into square root of x dx is equal to dt, or dx by root x is equal to 2 dt. Therefore we can write I is equal to 2 times integral dt by t. So this is equal to 2 log mod t plus c. We can substitute our t in terms of x. This is equal to 2 log mod root x minus 1 plus c. So we have got the answer for the 10th question, 1 by x minus root x. The next one, 11th one, x by square root of x plus 4. Here let us take I is equal to integral x by square root of x plus 4. We have to find methods in such a way that we can simplify this. So to do that, I am adding and subtracting 4. So let us take I is equal to integral x by square root of x plus 4. I am adding and subtracting 4 into dx. So we can take each term separately. This is equal to integral x plus 4 by square root of x plus 4 minus 4 integral dx by x plus 4. Here dx I forgot. So this is equal to integral square root of x plus 4 dx minus 4 integral x plus 4 the whole raised to minus half into dx. So now we can easily find the integral. Integral root of x plus 4 dx is x plus 4 the whole raised to half plus 1 by half plus 1. It is x plus 4 the whole raised to 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 minus 4 into x plus 4 the whole raised to minus half plus 1 by minus half plus 1 plus c. So this is equal to, it is 2 by 3 x plus 4 the whole raised to 3 by 2 minus 8 x plus 4 the whole raised to half plus c. I hope this is clear. Let us move on. The 12th question says you have to find the integral of x cube minus 1 the whole raised to 1 by 3 into x raised to 5. So let me rewrite this. You have to find the integral of this function. So I is equal to integral x cube minus 1 the whole raised to 1 by 3 into x raised to 5. I am writing it as x cube into 1 by 3 into 3x square dx. Here I have written x raised to 5 as x cube into x square. It is again x raised to 5 and I am multiplying and dividing. So let us see, we can rewrite this as, this is equal to 1 by 3 into x cube minus 1 the whole raised to 1 by 3 into x cube into 3x square into dx. Now let us put x cube minus 1 as t. So x cube will be t plus 1. Then if we differentiate, we get 3x square dx is equal to dt. Now we can substitute all these terms in our I. So we can rewrite I as, I is equal to 1 by 3 integral. We have taken x cube minus 1 as t. So integral t raised to 1 by 3 into x cube is nothing but t plus 1 into t plus 1, 3 x square dx is dt. So we have got I is equal to 1 by 3 into integral t raised to 1 by 3 into t plus 1 dt. So this is equal to 1 by 3 into, I am taking this inside. So, t raised to 1 by 3 into t is integral t raised to 4 by 3 dt plus 1 by 3 integral t raised to 1 by 3 dt. Now, we can easily apply the integral formula. So this is equal to 1 by 3 into t raised to 4 by 3 integral t raised to 4 by 3 dt is t raised to 4 by 3 plus 1 7 by 3 divided by 7 by 3 plus 1 by 3 into integral t raised to 1 by 3 dt is t raised to 1 by 3 plus 1 4 by 3 by 4 by 3 plus c. So these two will get cancelled. So we can substitute t in terms of x. So I is equal to 6 cube minus 1 the whole raised to 7 by 3 by 7 plus x cube minus 1 the whole raised to 4 by 3 by 4 plus I hope this is clear. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is x squared divided by 2 plus 3x cubed the whole raised to 3. Now we have I as integral x squared divided by 2 plus 3x cubed the whole raised to 3 dx. Let us put this 2 plus 3x cubed as t. So that on differentiating we get 9 x squared dx is equal to dt, which implies x squared dx is equal to 1 by 9 dt. So our given integral reduces to I is equal to 1 by 9 integral dt by t cubed. Dt by t cube is, it is integral. We can simplify this easily. So this is equal to 1 by 9 into t raised to minus 3 plus 1 is minus 2 by minus 3 plus 1 plus c. So this is equal to minus 1 by 18. We can substitute for t. T is 2 plus 3x cube into 1 by 2 plus 3x cube the whole square plus c. So we have got the answer for this. The next one is 1 by x into log x the whole raised to m, x greater than 0 and m not equal to 1. So let us take I is equal to integral dx by x log x the whole raised to m. Let us put log x is equal to t. Then dx by x will be equal to dt. So our I becomes dt by t raised to m. That is integral t raised to minus m dt. So we can integrate this function. This is equal to t raised to minus m plus 1 by minus m plus 1 plus c. We can substitute the value of t. So we get I is equal to t, we have taken log x. So log x the whole raised to 1 minus m by 1 minus m plus c. So we have got the answer. The next one is x by 9 minus 4x square. It is, let us take I is equal to integral x dx by 9 minus 4x square. This is quite simple. Let us put 9 minus 4x square as t. Then x dx will become 1 by minus 1 by 8 dt. I am writing it directly as we have done quite a few problems. Now let us substitute it in I. So I is equal to minus 1 by 8 integral dt by t. This is equal to minus 1 by 8 log mod t plus c, which is equal to minus 1 by 8 log mod 9 minus 4x square plus c. The next question, e raised to 2x plus c, that is we have to find the integral of e raised to 2x plus 3. This we can either substitute t is equal to 2x plus 3 or we can also write it directly. So integral I is equal to integral e raised to 2x plus 3 into dx. This is nothing but 1 by 2 e raised to 2x plus 3 plus c. Next question is x divided by e raised to x square. Here it is a slightly tricky question, but still it is easy to solve. That is, we have to find I is equal to integral x divided by e raised to x square dx. Let us put minus x square as t, because this is equal to integral x e raised to minus x square dx. So let us put minus x square as t, so that we get x dx as minus 1 by 2 dt. When we substitute in I, we get I is equal to integral minus half e raised to t dt. This is equal to minus half, we can take it outside. Integral e raised to t dt is e raised to t plus c. We can substitute t here. So t is minus x square. So I is equal to minus half integral e raised to minus x square plus c. I hope this is clear. The next question. E raised to tan inverse x by 1 plus x square. By looking at the question itself, we can see if we substitute t as tan inverse x, we will get dx by 1 plus x square as dt. So here our I is integral e raised to tan inverse x by 1 plus x square dx. So let us put tan inverse x is equal to t. Then dx by 1 plus x square will be equal to dt. Hence we have I is equal to integral e raised to t dt. This is equal to e raised to t plus c. So we have taken t as tan inverse x. Let us substitute that. So our I is e raised to tan inverse x plus c. The next question is e raised to 2x minus 1 divided by e raised to 2x plus 1. Here we have to do some slight rearrangement of the terms. I am taking this I is equal to 2 e raised to 2x minus of e raised to 2x plus 1. That is, 2 e raised to 2x minus e raised to 2x is e raised to 2x. Here minus into plus 1 is minus 1. So I am just rearranging some of the terms. Divided by e raised to 2x plus 1 into dx. So our I is integral 2 e raised to ta e raised to 2x minus of e raised to 2x plus 1 divided by e raised to 2x plus 1. So this is equal to 2 integral, or I can have write it here itself, e raised to 2x by e raised to 2x plus 1 dx minus integral e raised to 2x plus 1 by e raised to 2x plus 1 into dx. These two cancel out and we are left with 1. So for this, let us put e raised to 2x plus 1 as t. Then 2 e raised to 2x dx will become dt. Therefore, we will have I is equal to integral dt by t minus integral dx. So this is equal to log mod t minus x plus c. Now we can substitute t. We have taken t as e raised to 2x plus 1. So I is equal to log mod e raised to 2x plus 1 minus x. We can write it as log e raised to x plus c. So here it is in the form of log a minus log b. It is log a by b. It is so here we have log e raised to 2x plus 1 divided by e raised to x plus c. So this is equal to log e raised to x plus e raised to minus x plus c, because if we take each term separately, if we divide e raised to 2x by e raised to x, we get e raised to x plus 1 by e raised to x is e raised to minus x. Hence, I is equal to log mod e raised to x plus e raised to minus x plus c. The next question, we have to find the integral e raised to 2x minus e raised to minus 2x divided by e raised to 2x plus e raised to minus 2x. Now let us take I is equal to integral e raised to 2x minus e raised to minus 2x divided by e raised to 2x plus e raised to minus 2x dx. Now let us put e raised to 2x plus e raised to minus 2x as t. So 2 e raised to 2x minus 2 e raised to minus 2x into dx will be dt. That is, we will get the numerator now e raised to 2x minus e raised to minus 2x into dx is equal to dt by 2. If we take this 2 outside, we get e raised to 2x minus e raised to minus 2x into dx is equal to dt by 2. So we can substitute in our given integral. I is equal to 1 by 2 integral dt by t, because this whole term is dt by 2 and this denominator we have taken as t. So this is equal to half log mod t plus c. This is equal to half log t is nothing but e raised to 2x plus e raised to minus 2x plus c. So with this we have completed the first 20 questions of exercise 7.2. I hope this video was useful for you. Thank you for watching.